this video we will use the same program previously which we used created previous programs, and here we will use two operations. First we will copy the elements of from one array to another array, and we will reverse the array. So for that, let's do one thing, just remove this wherever we have this array. Now we have created an array. Now let's take another array, that is int a equal a. You can create array like this also, and this one is also correct. New int, many people confused between what to write here. Okay, so we have created the array, and we will create this array with same size. Now we will do copy for that. So here we will write, a for loop int j equals 0. J should be less than n, and j plus plus. I think you all will be familiar with the for loop. That is, this is initialization, this is condition statement, and this is expression. Now do you know this int j? I have declared int j. Now if I will use here in j, will it run the will it be compiled successfully? No, because these are all formal parameters. That these things are all formal parameters. So when you make a formal parameter, it will be only available to the method only. So the j data type variable will be available for this for loop only, not outside this for loop. Now what we will use, like we need to we have taken the array. Here we will write j, and here I will write the name of the previous array and j. Now instead it will display the previous array. So let me write here, copy, paste here, and update it. Previous array, okay. Yes, here I will write system.out.println. We'll change to new line. This will be previous array, and now let's change it, because I've declared the array with the a name, so we should write ar here. Okay, so now it's done, it's the previous array. And new array will be, the name of the array new will be a. So let's write me, and here we will write new array. So okay, it's done, let's compile it and run it. Sorry. Have you seen the array error? Like what I did, I used this array variable here, and it did not recognize my this variable because I've declared it here and it's available for this for loop only. It won't be available in this loop here. It won't be available here in this loop. It won't be available. So I will update it. Okay, 5 1 2 4 5 6. Okay, I think we have done something wrong. No, the thing happened is we did not added ln here. So we'll add ln here. Okay, and ln here and no new line here and no new line here. Now let's see what happens. 5 8 7 4 1 2. Okay, I did not commented it. Now we can see that we have to create for each loop many times. So why not make a for each loop once and use it anytime you want it. So it's showing the previous array and the new array. Now what we will do, we will make a array which will store the reversed elements of array. So we will continue this in this operation in the next video, and we'll make a new for it a method which will we can say that which will have to not to write for each loop every time. We just try define the call the method and it will run it. So we will make two programs in this next video. So that's it from this video. Thanks for watching.